Hotel Cafe, how y'all doing tonight? Well, thank you all for being here tonight. Tonight is the 40th anniversary, June 1st, 1984, of Springsteen's Born in the USA. I was 16 years old in August 2984. I went to see Springsteen in the Meadowlands for the first time with my boys, drinking warm beer out of an old Celica. And even then, I knew that I wanted to be here 40 years later with all these great musicians from Los Angeles. Give them all a big hand, thank you. So the whole idea tonight is to re-envision these songs in an Americana kind of way. I was always bothered with the way that all the synthesizers were took away from the river in Nebraska. And I was like, one day we're gonna be able to hear these songs the way you're supposed to hear these songs. And tonight we got some of LA's greatest songwriters, singers. We're gonna start off tonight with Johnny Marfa. I'm sorry, did you guys not know? This is Johnny fucking Marfa. That's better. There you go. Because you know times are tough, and it's just getting tougher. Put your hands together for LA's own Johnny fucking Marfa. Thank you. you out there, buddy. All right.
Yeah.
Next, we got one half of Whiskey Sunday. We got one half here.
Yep.
Aubrey Richmond over here on fiddle.
Hey, everybody. Thank you for supporting this tonight. I'm talking about the veterans on
them. I was going to do that right now. Oh, you want to do it?
No. You go ahead. You know more.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for supporting Hollywood
American Legion.
American Legion number 43.
So, I'm third generation American Legion member, although I'm not a veteran. They have a Sons of American Legion program up here on Highland. And when I came in, they didn't have much of a homeless veterans program. So we're working on putting that together. So the proceeds tonight are going to go to start this, to support the veterans that are homeless. So what a lot of people don't understand when they see veterans and why our government doesn't take care of them, part of the loophole is if you've been dishonorably discharged, you don't get support. So what ends up happening, people end up getting drafted, well, not drafted, when they join, they're not mentally stable and they find their way getting kicked out, and then they end up on the streets. So a lot of the people that you see on the streets who are veterans, that's what ends up happening. So we've got some members from the American Legion here, and just know that not only are we hearing some great music tonight, everyone here has been supporting starting something that's going to help somebody. So with that, Aubrey and Patrick.
Thank you.
Krieger, Aubrey Richmond, Whiskey Sunday. Coming up next, we have a great honky tonker down from the Long Beach area. Please welcome David Serby. David's got a new album out on Blackbird Records called Low Hanging Stars. It's been getting some great reviews. And he's got one of LA's most kick-ass bands I've ever seen. And he's one hell of a damn good man on top of all that. He tried. Please put your hands together for David Serby. So David, how's the traffic coming on up here tonight?
Easy.
Easy?
I spent the whole afternoon in Hollywood, so it took like 5 minutes.
And that's the way to do it, man.
Yeah.
So, I went to see Springsteen at the Forum on April 7th, and after all these years of seeing him, I saw him for the first time when I was 16 years old, and now, many years later, I'm 32 now. Now, mind you, my mother was 29 for 53 years. My father refused to let us tell it was any other age, so I'm sticking at 43. But what was interesting in seeing Springsteen over the years live was, as a kid, you're there, you're throwing your arms up in the air, you're with your best friends, and you're singing along, and you're not really thinking about what the narrative of these songs are, you're just singing the choruses. But as you get older, you start realizing that maybe I might be one of the characters in this song, or my heart might be broken, or my job is bothering me, or whatever it is. But then this last time, now in my 50s, hearing these songs again, and hearing them going backwards, and looking back at my life, and how these songs have been a soundtrack all the way through to now, and to see that he's coming towards the end of his career, there's a certain amount of mortality to it too. And I found myself crying, laughing, singing, and all the way through feeling all these amazing emotions. Now, it could have been the mushrooms. Could have been the mushrooms. Could have been the mushrooms. But I'd like to think that it was just the power of these songs. And thank you all for coming, because you believe in that too. So without any further ado, here's David Serby.
Was getting me, and the judge got me. man, put me straight away.
Springsteen tonight, his fucking spirit is here in this fucking room right now. Can you feel it?
Dude. Do you guys feel Springsteen's spirit?
Where's the saxophone? This is early Springsteen. He has not met the big man yet. But I can tell you, I play in a band called 9 Mile Station. And it's created this path to me meeting all these wonderful performers. And I have my own big man that I met that helped me get to our promised land. And he's sitting here right here. It's Fernando Perdomo. Stand up, give everybody. There you go. Fernando Perdomo is available for weddings, bar mitzvahs, and children's.
Produce your prog rock record.
Coming up next is one of Los Angeles' great female singer-songwriters. She's got a new album out. Please welcome Regina Ferguson to the stage.
All right, we got a highway song, and now we got a train song.
I got it all down at the lumberyard. All of my men.
So when I was in high school, my friend John Messenkoff and I, we used to write lyrics for songs, and he went to a different school. And separately, we would write lyrics for songs while we were supposed to be in class, working on our, whatever the hell we're supposed to be working on. But we would get home at night, and we'd spend all our time reading our lyrics to each other over the phone, back in the time where there were landlines. And I chose the words off this next song as my high school yearbook quote. And I did not have a mullet in 1984. I had one in 1999 by accident because I couldn't afford to put a haircut. So this song is called No Surrender. Well, let's give it up for the band, man. We got Taylor Cobb on guitar over here. Phil Parle piano on keys. The mighty Bliss Bowen, who also has a new record out. Give it up for Bliss. Back here on the pedal steel, Nick Cox from Topanga, California. On the drums, Matt Tecu. And coming up next, the patron saint of country Americana music here in Los Angeles. Ubiquitously seen on many, many stages with many, many different artists. And I can tell you from personal experience, he makes everything better when he's in the room. Please put your hands together for the great Ted Russell Camp.
Hey, good people, how you doing? Can we have a hand for Will and Hotel Americana putting this all right together?
Down, 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 down.
Coming up next is one of my favorite artists. I just stumbled upon her on some country western thing up in Moorpark a couple months ago. But every single time I see her, she impresses me more and more with her songwriting, her stagecraft, and just overall grace on the stage. Please put your hands together for Allie Angel.
Shotgun blast, triple times, hey.
That's there, you can pick up what you want, just send it to that one Venmo, it'll get distributed out to the artists that are here. Just make sure in the memo you put down what you bought and who you bought it from. Coming up next is another amazing female singer-songwriters. LA has so much talent here right now, and the Americana and country scene here is so vibrant, it's exploding. I urge you all to check everybody out here on their own, they all have their own projects. And coming up next, we have another girl. She's coming up with another album that's come out. Please put your hands together for Molly Cruz. So we're doing the 12 songs that are on the album. And then there are some B-sides that were released at the same time. And this was one of them. This was a song that was Bruce Springsteen's only number one hit. Well, two, sorry. There was Manfred Mann, Blinded by the Light, and then there was this one by Natalie Cole when she redid his Pink Cadillac. What's that? Aretha Franklin did this too, but she did not have no one hit with it. She's the only one. No, Aretha Franklin. I've never heard of her. But if you put your hands together in a little respect,
thanks, Will. It was so nice to bring to such a full room. Give it up for Will Hawkins for organizing this. Thank you. Wow. Maybe a little Pink Cadillac. Here we go. Please stand.
When
You guys feeling all right out there right now? Man, that's an Orange County hell yeah if I ever heard one, motherfuckers. We're halfway through. You guys aren't cruising yet? Let's try that again. How y'all doing out there out in the back? Let's do another hell yeah way in the back. Ready? Let's go. Hell yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Coming up next is one of my Venetian brethren, sister in music, and someone I admire very much, and someone watching her do what she does, not just with her music, but she's got a Tuesday night songwriter showcase at Desert Five Spot around the corner called Soft Spot, and she does a lot of shows around town. She gives me a run for money as far as like putting events together, and has an amazing following, and I think she's just absolutely golden. Please put your hands together for Chloe Kapp.
My name is Chloe Kapp. We're tangled here, so I'm going to be restricted to the stage. Fine. This song's called Dancing in the Dark, and it is about just that, what you all are about to do. Because I can't see any of you. Sit around getting older.
I was having way too much fun out there dancing. Here enough for Chloe Cat. Wow, that was fucking awesome. You know, I imagined in my head that this would be fun, and as an event producer, you start leaning into it in the days before, you have 97 different panic attacks. And as good as all these musicians are, they're all cats. And trying to wrangle these cats over the last month has been fun. So coming up next again, we have the madly talented David Serby.
They slapped the cuffs on Dirty 99.
Are you ready for I'm on Fire, Robert? So there's the surprise, it's gone.
Goodbye, goodbye, say goodbye, surprise.
So I'm going to tell the origin story of me being able to get to play with Aubrey Richmond. So I got to see her play with a bunch of different people, and I was really impressed with her songwriting, her guitar playing, singing, and fiddle playing. And when I was putting Nine Mile Station together, I was like, I want Aubrey Richmond in the band. But I had never met Aubrey Richmond, and I didn't know a whole lot of people in between. So I sent her an email that took 2 years for her to return. And what had happened was, by that time, Nine Mile Station had come out, and we had a bunch of friends in common, and we're, the band and myself are all much better for it. She's one of the most talented people here in LA, male or female. An absolute freaking rock star. Please put your hands together for the one and only Aubrey Richmond.
Thank you.
minutes too.
Right. I told them one story that we could get away with.
Coming.
You messed up the cellar. Where are you now? Now, where's Johnny Marvin? Johnny Marvin out there? That's it, man. Come on, what are you? So when we were throwing this together, there were some songs on the album that I just thought they were dated when they came out, and they just got more dated as time went on. So Johnny Marvin was one of the first people I called for this song, because I'm just like, man, we need to do something different with this song. We need to take it back from those who have been using it for ill-gotten ways. 34 ill-gotten ways, for those of you who are listening. Can everyone here count to 34? Yeah. 34 plus 45 equals fuck you. I'm into numerology. So here we go. This is called Born in the USA. And this is Johnny fucking Marvin.
Hey, give it up for Will motherfucking Hawkins, everybody. I say we do this all night again and you sing every motherfucking song, man. It's so good to see somebody have so much fun. Thanks for putting this together.
All right, let's have some fun with this one, huh? I'm gonna need y'all's help at some point, so show up.
See their old Uncle Sam said, "Boy, I don't think you quite understand what I..."
same goddamn road for over 200 years. We got nowhere to run, we got nowhere to go. Come on!
For it. How many Bruce fans are out there tonight? Woo! My $100 goes a long way in Hollywood. All right, coming up next, we've got a super talented gal who's on a show called Nashville, and she sings with Ali Angel and Chloe Cook Cat, who you saw earlier. Please put your hands together for the madly talented, beautiful Ringy Blake.
Listen, I might not be born in the USA, but I was born to run!
Wait, where did that accent come
from? I'm not doing that song there, but I just thought that would be funny.
Rainey, I thought you were from South Carolina. Where's this accent?
I'm from Australia, the deep south.
South Australia? Oh,
thank you so much. Give it up for Will on sound. Hey, and these awesome bartenders, make sure you give me a deep tip. Are you ready? I know the words, I know the words.
It's safe me out of the way.
Come on, man. to the songwriting. Although I got more subtext. Oh, that someone like interviewed him.
All right, when I was able to put this band together, there was a song out of Bruce's catalog that was my favorite. And I always wanted to be able to play it, and after all these years of so many bands and so many cover bands and so many people telling me I don't know that song, well, these guys in the band said the same thing, except for Phil. And Phil, hey Phil, that's Phil. We got a couple more songs together. This is Phil Puddle, piano over on the piano. We got Taylor Kropp on the guitars. We got Bliss Bowen over here, Bliss in a red dress. You can't fuck around when you come into a room with a red dress. One of those beautiful, talented gals here in LA. Back here on the pedal steel, Nick Cox from Topanga, California. Back on the drums, if any of you had seen the movie Echo in the Canyon, you saw this man play with Brian Wilson, Neil Young, Jackson Brown. This is Matt Tecker on the drums. And from Highland Park, California, Ted Russell Camp on the bass. Sorry, Bliss is up next. Sorry, Bliss.
It's okay, I'm from South Jersey, I can take it.
I know, I'm going to get a smack in the head.
Hey, anybody else representing South Jersey or any part of Jersey out there? Okay, it's sort of close. I want to sing it.
So a real Jersey girl is going to be singing a B-side from the 1984 single Jersey Girl, written by Tom Waits, but made famous by one and only Bruce Springsteen. And we have Allie Angel back here doing some backups. I'll be over here having a drink while you kill this. Give it up for Bliss Bowen.
See you.
All right, we got two more for you. All right, so this was the song I was talking about before. It's off Darkness on the Edge of Town. And it goes something like this. The kings are, there are pictures of heroes on the wall. Wait, let's do. Hold on a second. One, two, one, two, three. The candies room. The pictures of our heroes on the wall. Forget the candies room. Gotta walk the darkness. The candies hall. Strangers from the city, call my babies on earth. They bring her toys. But our Glenn smiles pretty. She knows I wanna be candy's boy. There's a sadness hidden in a pretty face. Sadness all alone, from which no man can keep candy safe. We kiss the hollows to your own, the loss of the two to their own.
Next time. Yeah, well.
this tune. Good night, everybody.
This is Will Hawkins. He put this whole line together. Give it up for Will Hawkins. Can you please give it up for Will Hawkins? All proceeds go to Hollywood. American Legion 43. Please give it up for Will Hawkins.
Thank you, everybody. We'll see you next time. Good night.